So I was sitting there trying to think of ideas to do for videos and stuff like that, and I figured what's the easiest thing to do than to do a vlog. I don't really know specifically what I'm even going to be talking about right now, so I literally just put my camera on a tripod, got it all set up, and just hit record. So that's where we are. So if you, something like that, I don't know. So, yeah, as you can see, I've got a pretty blurry background here. I'm using an 85 millimeter lens. I just bought a Sony a7 R4, and you're probably thinking, oh my God, why would you do that? That's so many megapixels, it's stupid. I think the same thing, except for the fact that if you crop it down to super 35 millimeter, you get around like 24, 26 megapixels, which my old camera was, and it was the same crop factor. So it's like, I get two cameras in one camera, essentially. And I recently got a printer, so I've been printing things out, and it's been a lot of fun. So that's just a couple of the things that that I've been doing here recently. I haven't really been getting out to take any photos, just because I haven't really wanted to go out much right now, but I do want to get out at some point. It's just very difficult. So, but what else? Yeah, so my girlfriend and I have been, since we've been, I got this printer, I was like, oh, well, let's print something out. Let's do something as like a fun exercise and stuff like that. So, last video I mentioned and showed a Luffy wanted poster from One Piece. We've recently been working on Zoro here, and I'll show you one of those. Let me show you a non-colored one, if I can find it. Here we go. This is a non-colored one. So my girlfriend did this. If I get the colored one, you won't be able to tell because it's in color and the video is not. But you can get a gist of it. There you go. Just imagine him with green hair and blood coming down his face. And a slightly off-white shirt and gold earrings, you know? Just picture that. There you go. You did it. I'm sorry. But yeah, I guess I could shoot this in color, but I don't really want to. That's another one of the things. My photography is, I've kind of changed. I used to just strictly do a lot of things in color, and now I've gotten to the point where I don't want to do anything in color. I find color so distracting, and it's partially because I don't know, I guess, framing with things and with color and stuff like that. It's very, I don't know, I get very distracted. The other good thing about this camera is that I can actually set it up to use the viewfinder and the screen on the back to show everything in black and white, but it will not change. Like, I'm shooting in RAW format, so it's not going to change anything with the pictures. The pictures will be in color, but I see everything in black and white. And that has been so beneficial for me, because then I just feel like I could not see anything when there's, like, so much color. It gets very distracting for me. So being able to do that with this camera is just, I don't know, it's amazing. Everything looks so much better in black and white to me, and I kind of wish that part, I wish I could just put some glasses on and then just see everything in black and white for certain specific times, but yeah, and I find that if I saw everything in black and white, I could probably find things a whole lot better. I'm very bad at finding things. I will search and search for something, and it will be sitting right in front of me. And it's comical, but annoying, because I live with it. So it's like every day. I recently went back home and got some of my photo gear, which sparked me to kind of want to pursue some more photography stuff. Then it made me want to pursue getting a printer and printing stuff out. And so now it's like all of these things are kind of coming together that I've wanted for a while, and I'm just now doing them because I have the energy and I have the skill to do a lot of different things. I don't do things like on a, I don't get to a professional level on most things that I do, but I do get to a level in which I could compete with people like that, I assume. So I guess I could do things on a professional level, but I'm very good at just random things. I guess they wouldn't really be random because they're just things that I'm interested in. So I get really interested in certain things and I get really good at those things. Like doing weathering. So like weathering on like gunpla and stuff like that. Not you're gonna hunt, aren't you? No. Come on. Come on. Focus. Am I doing the weathering on these guys? And I see this is where I'm like, why did I do this in black and white? But look at the eye. Well, it's not gonna focus on that, is it? I don't know. So I love doing things like that, and I do other. I have another one here. But get really good at certain things. And then do nothing with it. I get good at something, and then I'm like, okay, I've mastered this as much as I want to master this. I don't want to go any further because then I'd have a huge, a bigger time sink. And yet, like, I should be doing that. Because, yeah, I will get to a certain point. I'm like, wow, this is great. Now I never want to do that again because I've just spent months researching some random thing. Months just sticking at one project, and it leads to nowhere. It leads to me knowing a bunch of stuff, but me not knowing how to use that, applying that stuff. I don't know how to apply any of the information, or I don't know how to apply any of the skills that I've created to everyday life, or even in a job. Because it's just, I don't know. I don't know. This has just been me rambling on and on, and I may not edit this video, just because this is kind of a stream of thoughts and how I see things, I guess. Like I'll go back. I wish that I could see in black and white, and then we'll keep on going. I bounce around a lot mentally, just like everywhere, and it's kind of annoying, but it's okay, I guess. I forget things a whole lot, but yeah. So back to some of the mental health stuff. Yeah, I've been having a lot of problems here over the years where I just get into these states where I just don't want to do a single thing and I can't do anything. I don't want to go anywhere. I don't want to talk to anybody. I was recently diagnosed with as bipolar. I have OCD, and that was something that probably should have been more apparent to me a long time ago. PTSD, obviously. Not obviously, y'all don't know why I have PTSD, but I have PTSD for probably a couple of different reasons. There's probably about three or four different reasons. I'm sitting here spinning back and forth because it's a kind of a tough thing to talk about for anybody. I'm generally an open person, but I don't like to open up and let people know. I don't like letting people in as much, and so I'm trying to do that. So, and hopefully getting this out helps me get rid of some of this anxiety that I have over everything. I get anxious about anything. It's like I just worry. So, but yeah, I've decided that I'm not gonna edit this video. It's gonna be 10 minutes long, but it's whatever. So, but yeah, this has just been me rambling. No point to this video. So if you're watching this video and you made it this far, I do appreciate it. Please don't think that I am crazy, because I partly am, but it I don't like using that word, but I think it can be a fun word if you use it in a fun way. But yeah, I don't know. I probably shouldn't say that. I don't even think anybody should use the word crazy, and yet here I am. I don't know. Either way, I'm trying to end this video, and I can't even end the video. So, all right. Well, I'll catch you all later. Please subscribe if you want more content like this, of just of this sad boy over here. Just talking to a camera by himself. So, I really do appreciate it. You made it this far. Thank you. So, see ya.